1-year trip home. This is so good to be home. Thank you. A couple things before the show starts. Yeah, I know we got a pirate theme this year. I apologize for not having a pirate guard. That's the best I can do. Long story short, I found out that all of my stuff that was in storage had lights water damage. Yeah, so they had to throw it all away. I don't keep them personally because, you know, mice are small. And if they're going to do all that water damage, they've got to create these small little bugs. One thing in here, drop stuff up. So the short end of the story is I don't have an iron guard to wear. Sit back, relax, enjoy yourself. Where did I put my notes? I never said it was organized. We're going to start the show with a little song. You guys remember something called Road 66? A little song that was sung by Amanda? She did a song for Road 66 with Baltimore, night featuring Pharaoh, ladies and gentlemen. She needs to get a crowd chanting for the name Rockstraw. Can you guys do that for me?
Sure.
Sure? Come on, how about excitement? You guys want to hear it? Are you ready? So I want to hear it really loud. Rockstraw! Rockstraw!
Rockstraw!
December 14th, so stay tuned there, watch there for it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
one, and no, I don't have a damn receipt.
Well, sir, if you have our technical support, I can look you up your account and see what I can do for you.
I don't have that either. Only morons buy extended warranties.
I'm sorry, but due to our policy, the only thing I can do is fix it at your expense then.
That is ridiculous. I'm not gonna pay for something that shouldn't have broken in the first place.
Well, let's take a look at it. Maybe it's something that can easily be remedied. What is this? Did you shovel your car out of snow with this thing? There's keys missing and the screen is busted. You might as well buy a new freaking laptop.
Is there a problem here?
Yes. Your guy here is being rude to me. And he was just going on about his policies and what he can't do.
I'm sorry about that. Come with me and we'll get you taken care of.
Good afternoon, sir. How can I help you?
I'm trying to install Windows 8, but I can't get it to work. I paid $299 for this crappy software. You need to fix it.
Sure, I can get that all fixed up for you. Do you have technical support with us?
No. How much more is that going to cost me?
It's $200 for unlimited software support.
This is some racket you have here.
I'm sorry, but I'm not allowed to work on your computer without it.
Fine.
There you go. It's installed. Thank you, sir. Have a nice day.
I need your help. I can't get on the web. And here's my technical support account number.
The network card is bad and needs to be replaced. I'll have to check it in for a few days until the part comes in.
No, no! I need my computer. I must have my Farmville. I can't be without my Farmville. Have you ever played Farmville?
No, I have never played Farmville.
It's the best thing ever. I played it like every day.
Well, I guess another option is to buy a new computer. I can have it ready for you to play your game within the hour.
What? I can't wait that long. I need it.
I must.
Stick outside, lady.
No, I must attend to my mangoes. My mangoes!
Are you all right?
Yeah, but I don't think I can handle another difficult customer today.
Broadcasting live from Midwest Furfest 2013. Top of the news is a local wine shortage. Citizens all over have reported an inability to purchase white wine in any quantity. Authorities suspected a scalping scheme at first, but dropped their investigation upon learning about Uncle Kage in the area. In related tragic news, I'm not drunk. Scotch donations can be made to the Bulge. Officials of MFF have declared the con theme of pirates rousing success, since not a single ninja has been sighted thus far. We thank the pirates for their service. In world news, it turns out First Squared, a con in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, is the same weekend as Vancouver in Vancouver, British Columbia. While both wish each other the best, Vancouver would like to bribe you with cheese and gravy, while First Ward would like to offer cheese and guns. And now, a word from our sponsor. Are you tired of your pet dog, bird, or even children making sound that's inappropriate or undesirable? Then Woof's Barks are for you. No more yapping, yipping, whining, or squeaking. Only barks. Put an end to childlike complaining. Just barks. Want to spice up your love life? Add barks to the mix. Woof's Barks are the strongest around, so don't wait. Get Woof's Barks today. Use at your own risk. Woof's Barks are not meant for feline installations. Woof's Barks are not guaranteed. And we're back. An anonymous tip has reported that there are 500 ninjas in this room right now. In the sports arena, a furry was playing poop-poop golf and stunk a hole-in-one. For boxing, the verbal match between Two and Kage resulted in a draw, and in my love life, I struck out. Rounding out this update, we'd like to pass on some words from the Cannes Hotel. Do you shower? Don't golden shower. Do scoot through the halls in a timely, orderly fashion. Don't butt scoot on the carpet. And lastly, do enjoy yourselves at the con, but don't enjoy others without their permission. You've been listening to WFUR. Stay tuned for Hands Where They Don't Belong with the Muppet Barbershop Quartet.
Anybody? I can't be the only one. I'll stop now. So we've had Nirvana. I think we should kind of keep within the same kind of tune, same kind of tone, but I think we should upshift a little bit. We have Seneca with April. Everybody, never let me set up a dog about my word.
Oh.
I got no arm! Let's get whatever bag I can get. I'm a dog! I'm supposed to catch, not throw! What can I do? I do have a question for you guys. I do get a volunteer from the audience, not for this act, but for the one following this. All I'm allowed to say is that it has something to do with Animal Crossing. Oh. Standing up in the background on the white shirt, come on up this way. Come on around this way over here. We're going to get you set up for the next act. We'll get just go around about there, that's where the backstage area is. They'll get y'all set up. Talk amongst yourselves for a minute. Better yet, let's get Andrew Shatter to do it for you.
Hi, everybody!
selling of items.
And customizing them, of course.
Oh, speaking of items, there seems to be one recycled from everyone here at MFF. I forgot to price them. My, aren't you a fine hair, Lizzie?
I better not catch you making goo-goo eyes on my wife, or I'll make you see things in 4D.
Oh, Cyrus. Oh, here comes a customer. Hi, welcome to retail. May I help you with anything today? Oh, well, don't hesitate to ask me if you have any questions about recycling. Feel free to browse around our store. Oh, I see you're interested in our... Achoo! Excuse me, my human allergies must be coming back. This fine item will cost you 9,001 bells. Are you interested in purchasing? All right. Enjoy your purchase.
Yo, what can I do for your coursework?
Don't you go falling for my Psy Guy now. I mean, Hoss has an item that you would like to be customized.
Oh, a project, you say? I'll be the judge of that. Let me see if anything you got interests me. Oh, you got something interesting here. Mind if I take a closer look? Appears you got yourself a furry here. Cool. Arms, we can customize that. I'll do it for 101 bells. That sound fair?
Oh, that's my Psy Guy.
Cool. Your order will take about 10 seconds. Why don't you kill some time?
Iris, honey, hurry up. We got a customer waiting.
Done. Your order's all curdied up.
Thank you for visiting retail. Have a great day.
And to all you folks out there,
have a great MFF from your friends at retail.
Thank you. back the hands of time. You better believe I can. I can make the seasons change just by the wave of my hand. I can turn everything from old to new. But the thing I wanna do the most comes right into do. I'm an unhappy person without all these powers I possess. Cause oh man, you're the key to my happiness. Can't you see these tears I'm crying?
I can't get next to you.
Oh, it's you that I need.
I can't get next to you.
Can't you see these tears I'm crying?
I can't get next to you.
Thank you.
Spirit needs some here. You know, I was going to say that song is moving, but apparently it's still isn't. What? There's one joke that's sitting right there, and I'm not taking it. Because I know if I do, I'm going to get thrown off the stage. You'll all probably. Every once in a while, when you're new to the variety show, you got to drop the transmission, go from reverse to fifth gear. So let's talk geek. I know everything about geek. Okay, I know what he's thinking. He's thinking of the pencil neck and never got dated. When I'm talking geek, I'm talking about the circus sideshow geeks. I'm talking about the early 1900s or so. You had your main show, you had the sideshow geeks, you had your freak, you had your geek, you had working men. We got a working man tonight. That sounds so wrong. I'm gonna shut up now. I'm just gonna let Zell.
Your socks.
Yeah.
What? I was so thrilled when they told me that they were bringing back one of my favorite
convention themes. So, everybody, y'all love Carnival, right?
Yeah!
Oh, yeah. So, let's do some sideshow acts. Huzzah!
Woo! How does this grab?
Now, for those of you in the front, you can see this. For those in the back, you can hear this. For those of you who are easily squicked, close your eyes and pretend it's a musical act. Because there is a long, upstanding history in circus freaks and circus geeks. The human blockhead. Oh, some of you know this one. Yes, this is a real nail. Yes, this is a real hammer. This I'm not so sure about, but we'll figure it out. There we go. Now, like I was saying,
I might as well want to say, that is a pirate theme. I think we should be something a little piratey. Hey, guys. Yeah, you guys back in there. Can we get some piratey from the lights? I don't know. Seaside edge. Little. Okay, who summoned Cthulhu? The guy with the squeaky toy, I know it.
There you go.
All those, if we do have a piratey theme con, I think we should have a piratey theme song. We have Redstorf, Magnus Dierman, Victor Redtail, Farina, proving that all pirates can't be trusted. They should probably be healed.
Thank you. Hi. What I did on my summer vacation. Sweat. A lot. I sweat so much that I could do slip and slide without water. My Uncle Randy had me in his pool, the little SpongeBob pool, and he had little people wrestle in the pool. They always had these weird names like Mildly Brisk Steve Boston and the Pebble. But it was okay because he paid me in lemonade, but it tasted weird, made me dizzy, and I crashed my power wheels. Also this summer, my sister became a vegan because she can't spell vegetarian. My mom said she was going to take us to Disney World, me and my sister, but we took us out to the backyard, and it was just a globe with a Mickey Mouse hat. I turned to my sister, and that's when I learned of vegan rage. She punched my mom in the nose, she fell back in the vegetable garden, and she was stabbed by a carrot. Also, my brother went to college, and all he does now is listen to Arcade Fire, and my dad says he looks like an anorexic lumberjack. I wanted to send him a drawing I did for him. It's a sad ninja because he's a pirate stuck in a ninja's body. And anyway, I was looking for some stamps, but I couldn't find any stamps. And I found these colorful stamps in my dad's drawer. And when I licked the stamp, I was surrounded by griffins. They kept on screaming, "God save the Butter Queen! God save the Butter Queen!" and shot rainbows from their mouths and confetti from their butts. And I ran and ran and ran and woke up on a beanbag chair at a Grateful Dead concert. Last thing we did on our summer vacation, we ran into a parade. And by ran into, my dad hit a float with his car. I think it was a Father's Day parade because it said Leather Daddies on it. When the people fell off the float, it was like an avalanche of manliness. The parade was great because there was all these happy people with little shorts and angry people with big signs. But we had to leave the parade early because my mom got mad because too many people at the parade said they knew my dad from the gym. And that's my summer vacation.
You know, I was talking about vegans and vegetarians. If you're a vegan, I do apologize, but I always kind of hold that, you know, vegetables are what food eats. I can't. What am I supposed to do with this? Okay, I can't catch either, apparently. Yar. What do you think? Part of me just wants to throw this at somebody now. I don't know why. Nothing like having a weapon makes you want to do that. No, I'm not throwing anything. Because if I hit you, then, you know, the people at the concert get really angry at me, and then they make me go home. And I have to live on a doghouse all day, and that's not very much fun, especially in the weather outside. I gotta take a breath. I'm trying. I just realized it's a really bad idea to hold a sword like that. My dog, what do you expect? Never. So, our next... Oh, you guys are right. Oh, all right. I see. So our next act, we have Get More Piracy. Not called in the internet. We have Major Eric Adler. Eric Alder. Mountain Blue Joe Bob. I cannot read my own writing. Mountain Blue Fox Joe and North Fox presenting us with the Lincoln Park Pirates.
In Chicago, where I live, there's an outfit that'd tow almost anything off the street. They deal mostly with automobiles, and we call them the Lincoln Park Pirates. The street lamps are on in Chicago tonight, and lovers are gazing at stars. The stores are all closing, and Daly is dozing, and the fat man's counting the cars. And there's more cars and places to put them, he said, but I got room for them all. So around them up, boys, cause I want some more toys at the lot by the grocery store. To me, way, hey, toll away, the Lincoln Park Pirates are we. From Wilmette to Gary, there's nothing so hairy, and we always collect our fee. To me, way, hey, toll away, we plunder the streets of your town. Be it Edsel or Chevy, there's no car too heavy, and no one can make a shutdown. We break into cars when we gotta, with pickaxe and hammer and saw. And they said this garage had no license, but little care I for the law. All my drivers are friendly and courteous, they're good manners you always will get, cause they all are recent graduates of the charm school in Joliet. Tell me, hey, hey, oh, away, the Lincoln Park Pirates are me. From Wilmette to Gary, there's nothing so hairy, and we always collect our fee. To me, hey, hey, oh, away, we plunder the streets of your town. Be it Edsel or Chevy, there's no car too heavy, and no one can make us shut down. And when all the cars are collected, and all of their fenders are ruined, then I'll tow every boat in Belmont Harbor to the Lincoln Park Lagoon. And when I've collected the ransom, and sunk all the ones that won't yield, then I'll tow all the planes that are blocking the runways at Midway, O'Hare, and Bakersfield. To me, way, hey, tow away, the Lincoln Park Pirates are me. From Wilmette to Gary, there's nothing so hairy, we always collect our fee. To me, way, hey, tow away, now citizens gather around, and I think it's enough, and let's call it bluff, let's tow the bum out of town.
There's a bunch of youngsters in the audience, but they used to do this airport downtown Chicago called Bakersfield. Wow, I'm striking out. Nobody remembers any of the old stuff from Chicago.
I do.
Santa's Village?
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you.
Been there.
You guys remember the quartet earlier? They're going to be auctioning these off, I guess, for the cherry. So if you're interested in that, head over to the cherry auction, I guess, tomorrow. Yeah, go ahead, just ignore me. Throw me to the wolves. I don't care. No offense to the wolves. But they're going to be auctioning these off, I guess, tomorrow, right? Catch. He didn't catch either. I don't feel so bad anymore. I don't know. Our next act, I have no idea what's coming. Every once in a while, they'll just throw me one, say go for it. So I have no idea exactly what's happening here. All I know is that Roxy Raccoon, Northpaw, Eric Alder, and Wild Fox are going to perform a dance number called Chirpy Chirpy Sheep. Sheep. Your guess is as good as mine, folks.